That 9 days fasting I was doing, after some days, the Lord brought some angels and they took my two hands and then they plugged it in something that looked like electricity. And it seemed as if I began to charge. My whole body wanted to burst into two. Hey, I wanted to tell God, it's too much, oh, stop. And I remember that Benny Hinn wanted to make the same prayer. I said, I told myself, Oga, you don't have much. Use this opportunity. It is after some of those encounters, my prayer changed. I started crying for capacity. I started crying for capacity. I started crying for capacity. Many of you, your undoing is the smallness of your capacity. God wants to do a big thing, but your vessel is small. It cannot accommodate heavy matters. Let me show you something. Show me Acts chapter 1 verse 8. But ye shall receive power. Say after me, ye shall receive power. Obviously, you already know the meaning of that word receive. That word receive there is lambano. Say after me, lambano. So there are two Greek words in the New Testament for receive. One is dekomai, presenting a possibility of passivity in your attempt to lay hold on things. But there is another one, receive, that is lambano, suggesting a possibility of violence. That this is a kind of person that has appeared at a point in his life where he is tired of just going on without something. Huh? Somebody that will come and say, anoint me or kill me. Endue me with power. Huh? Or leave me alone. How can I be seeing what you told me to do? I can't do anything about it. A.A. Allen said, I can't put food in my mouth. If you will not endure me, leave me. Let me go and do another thing. This is lambano. Say after me, lambano. He said, ye shall lambano power after that the Holy Ghost is come where? Upon. Huh? You know, some people said, I was talking to some people, they said, they have the Holy Ghost. That is one of the mistakes that people make. If you notice that your doctrine is inconsistent with accurate experience, we are not saying to exalt experience above doctrine. We are saying go and search well. It might mean that there is something in your doctrine that is not perfect, that is not complete. So when a man comes and tells us that you have received the Holy Ghost baptism and then you have power now, Allen said that people taught him and said that when you receive Holy Ghost baptism, the power has come. And then he stepped out with his shalabanga, shalabanga. You know, there are people, their tongues, since 5 years of Holy Ghost baptism, you know their tongues, shalaganda, shalaganda, mamba, mama, 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 mama. Mama, 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 5 years, 1 year passed. Mama, 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 mama. 2 years, mama, 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 mama. Kuli, kuli, kuli. Mama, mama. 3 years, 4 years. If you are the father of that child, will you be happy? That after 5 years, your child is in mama, makuli, mama, makuli. I will take you to the doctor. We need to check you. Something is wrong. I will take you to the past. That this my child can only say daddy and mommy, which is not bad. Eh? I'm not saying to stop your kuri kuri and my mama, but I'm saying that a child of 5 years that is only saying daddy that is good is a big trouble. You should know how to ask for food. You should know how to demand for some things. The Bible says ye shall speak with new tongues. The more you grow in God, there is kayanos to your tongues. There is freshness. Even if the syllables have not changed, there is a freshness in it. That freshness brings a measure of power and vitality. It's not ma-ma-ma-ma-kuli, ma-ma-ma-kuli, like something that is dead and dying. Ma-ma-ma. You see the way it's even sounding, ma-ma-ma-kuli, is just dying and dying and dying and dying. Because ma-ma-ma-kuli. I'm sorry if your tongue is ma-ma-ma-kuli, just forgive me for today. But ma-ma-ma-kuli can make a man to sleep in the night. Imagine when you woke up by 2. Or 1, and you want to pray, and you are doing mama makuri, mama 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 makuri. Why won't you sleep? But imagine if you are doing yakapambre abata da 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 da. You can't sleep with that one. You can't. No. How can you sleep? Even the witch in your compound will not sleep. But the witch is sleeping when you are doing mama makuli. Until you change into. And your neighbor came and said, I don't know what this your son is doing. It's not prayer. Go and ask your son what he's doing. Go back to that place and do it again. Can we pray for 1 minute? Put your hands in your belly. Out of my belly. Bow. Bow.
Kayanos, 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 fresh tongues, Kayanos, fresh tongues, Kayanos, Kayanos, rivers. Many of you have drunk only one river. Meanwhile, the scripture said, rivers. Today, you will drink another river. Kayanos, from your belly. Kayanos, from your belly. Kayanos. Kayanos! A new well, oh God. Dig a new well. A new fountain. A new fountain. A new fountain. A new depth. A new fountain. A new depth. A new fountain. From today, when you pray in tongues, it will carry much more fire, much more power, much more life. Kayanos! Let the freshness of the Spirit come upon our belly.